The lineups for Game 5, unchanged from the past couple of games at Madison Square Garden. The Knicks have been forced to play Allen Houston and Latrell Sprewell heavy, heavy minutes. 44 minutes per game for each of them in this series. In the case of Houston, for example, 8 minutes above his regular season average per game. Let's check with Ahmad.
All right, thanks, Bob. I talked to Greg Popovich before the game. He's talking about closure. He said tonight is the night. They want to put this team away, come out strong. He says they let them hang around. They're way too dangerous. They lose tonight, they could be in trouble. He said to a man on this team, their goal, win tonight, pick up that NBA trophy. Let's go down to Jim Gray.
All right, Ahmad, thank you very much. Well, that's exactly what is bothering the New York Knicks. About 3 hours before the game, a couple of the early arriving Knicks showed up to shoot around and warm up. Well, they weren't permitted out on the court because the NBA was practicing for the trophy presentation should the Spurs win. Now, Jeff Van Gundy came out, took it all in, was very pensive, said he found it very interesting. He said it served as a wake-up call to his team and that many of them were quite upset. I spoke to Allen Houston. He said it was very annoying, that many of his teammates are also very annoyed. But he went on to say, however, that there'll be no trophies being lifted here tonight at the Garden. Bob?
Well, the refrain is a familiar one by now. Not in our house. Let's see if the Knicks can make it stick. Mario Elie, big game in Game 4, 18.6 rebounds, rebounding from a tough Game 3 here. Avery Johnson has some daylight. Brings it back outside to Elie, 5 on the 24. Johnson, baseline jumper, way short, air ball. Sprewell has it. Houston to Larry Johnson between two defenders who make him miss. Duncan with his first rebound. He snared 18 in Game 4. Robinson, the move he likes best, across the lane, moving right to left. But the ball belongs to the Knicks.
Bob, I think you could see in that first possession with New York, Jeff Van Gundy saying, we need Larry Johnson to score. They run the first play for him. But once again, Tim Duncan just too big for him inside. He couldn't finish.
Sprewell. It spins out for him. Duncan, another rebound. Sprewell has that move a bit like Michael Jordan, where he separates himself from the defender for the jumper. Sean Elliott off the dribble into the lane and a whistle.
Remember now, in Game 4, San Antonio made a very conscious effort to get Elliott and Avery Johnson in the game early. And then Duncan and Robinson took over late. You see a little bit of that right now as we see Greg Popovich. But Bob, it was interesting. We went through the stats. 31 screen rolls in Game 4. 31 screen rolls the entire first three games. They used to get movement and get these guys involved in the game.
Elliott hits the first. Sean Elliott was the number three pick of the entire draft a decade ago in 89 after Purvis Ellison and Danny Ferry and just before Glenn Rice.
Well, he's a very underrated defender. What happened the other night is when Mario Elie picked up a quick foul, he moved over to play Allen Houston. So we'll have to watch as the matchups go tonight. But again, they need a big effort from Sean Elliott.
Spurs with the game's first points. Sprewell gets into the paint but can't finish. Duncan over Johnson, doesn't get the bounce. Houston, nice move. Started a drive, slammed on the brakes, hit the short pop.
And that's a very difficult shot when you're driving like that to be able to plant yourself and pull up. And he saw that shot blocker coming over, made a nice effort there to get that little jumper.
From 20 feet, Tim Duncan is perfect.
Now, that doesn't happen by accident, Bob. I was out here watching them shoot around before the game, and he must have shot for about 20 minutes in that same spot.
Sprewell around Elliott. A few misses will not discourage Latrell. He's now 1 for 3. Duncan, Johnson with a touch foul, his first. Didn't take much for that whistle.
when you roll out and hit this little jump shot, then the next time down the floor, what occurs is the defensive man has to close out. That's exactly what happened. Duncan hits it. The next time Larry Johnson comes out, puts his hand on him, and it's a foul.
Elliott for three. Overshot it. Robinson has the rebound, but a loose ball foul on Mario Elie, his first. The officials are Bennett Salvatore, Steve Javy, and Joe Crawford.
We'll have to watch now. Mario Elie, one of the real keys to the Game 3 win here for New York was he picked up two quick fouls guarding Allen Houston. He has one. Let's see if they go right to Houston here to try to get a second.
Tied at four. Houston. He has scored either 19 or 20 points in three of the games. The Knicks have lost those three. The night he scored 34, they notched their lone victory of the series. Duncan, two men on him. Ball poked away, Spurs keep it. Actually, there's a foul on the play, and it's on Marcus Camby, who was in foul trouble in the first three games of the series, but not in game four, when he had his best outing, 20 points, 13 rebounds.
Well, he stayed away from those kind of fouls the other night. Remember in game three, he picked them up so quickly. Got to stay away from those touch fouls.
Elie goes to the floor.
There it is. That's a touch foul where he jumped out on that screen roll.
And tripped him.
And Mariola drove the ball into him. Now Camby's got two. Now you're going to have to come in with Kurt Thomas. And this is how games are changed from the start. See, Camby takes a very poor angle to try to get out on that screen. And when he does, and foul trouble, Bob, you can see in games one, points and fouls. And then finally in game four, he broke out, stayed out of foul trouble. Now he has to sit down. He played 3.5 minutes.
Entering this game, the Spurs have taken 116 free throws in the series. The Knicks, 89. Duncan. Gets it back from Elie. Back to Elie for the set shot that's no good, and Elliott flies in trying to finish it. But it'll be New York ball.
Sean Elliott very upset there, Bob. He thought he got fouled on that play. Looked like he had good control of it. One of the New York players looked like they hit his wrist.
Larry Johnson shoved him from behind, but no call. Knicks lead it 6-4. Charlie Ward misses the three. Duncan over Johnson. Coming in for the rebound is Sprewell. That time Johnson was left alone, and he's at about a 6 or 7 inch height disadvantage. Sprewell pulls up and misses. It bounces to Avery Johnson, who brings it back the other way. Elie to David Robinson, follows his own shot. Hits it, plus the foul. Meanwhile, Charlie Ward's on the deck. He and the fans wanted the charge. It went just the other way. Robinson got the basket, plus the foul on top of it against Kurt Thomas, his first.
Well, let's see if Charlie Ward's feet are in that no block area. It looks like his foot might be in that little dotted line area. If it is, it has to be either a no call or a block. And actually, David Robinson with a follow. More importantly, Bob, that's already five fouls now for New York. So San Antonio will shoot free throws the rest of the quarter. And you talked already about how important that free throw line has been in this series.
The Spurs have made just two of their first nine shots, but lead 7-6. Sprewell. Tough luck on the shot. Now he has it back. Houston for three. Avery Johnson into the paint. Elliott all alone. Sean Elliott misses what would have been a three-pointer. Ward pegs it ahead to Sprewell. Between two defenders, left hand, bumped by Elliott, and a foul. Sprewell is at the line after being fouled by Elliott, Sean's first. Sprewell's 1-for-5 from the floor. Now he hits the free throw. Game four was a typical game for him in this series. Made 9 of 22. That's basically what he's done. 9 of 22, 10 of 24. But he's averaging 26 points. Except for game one, he's gotten to the foul line a lot.
Well, when you talk to Greg Popovich, the one thing he says is we want to keep Allen Houston and Sprewell off the free throw line. So if they shoot a lower percentage, they won't get their numbers. And when they've scored well, Bob, as you said, they've gotten to that line.
Avery Johnson into Duncan, but it's swiped away by Sprewell. He takes off, and all Avery Johnson can do is grab him.
If there's a concern for San Antonio, they've been very careless with the basketball the last few basketball games. They had 17 turnovers the other night, and New York thrives off this. The quickness of Sprewell. Watch him get back in the passing lane. Read it all the way. And again, once he gets that rim in focus, he is not going to stop until either gets there or gets fouled.
And so he's back at the foul line. When he gets the ball in the open court, it's a bit like Gale Sayers on a broken field run. You're at his mercy.
It's like he picks up speed. The minute that ball gets in his hand, he gets faster. Every dribble is just a little bit faster. But, Bob, another reason why New York must play ahead is because they want to be able to use Dudley. And if they get behind, it puts them in such a bind because he can't score. They're playing 4-on-5, so they need a cushion when they bring him in.
Here's the Admiral spinning on Thomas and missing the reverse. Ward's pass for Houston is off his hands. He argues that he was fouled. The Spurs, meanwhile, shooting at a glacial clip, 2 for 11, but trailing by only a basket. Robinson over Thomas.
See, that's your concern now. They're 3 of 12, and the game is tied. And if you're in New York with this cold spell, that's when you want to get that little cushion. Play ahead. They've got to get it out of this first quarter. They need the lead.
Larry Johnson with Duncan on it. Surrounded by Spurs, goes to the hook and gets the roll.
Well, he needed that kind roll. But once again, the degree of difficulty on those shots for Larry Johnson, he's been so cold from the three-point line, 2 of 15, that he wants to continue to drive it, and he's shooting over those 2 7-footers on every occasion.
Part of the reason why he's shooting 28% in the series. Duncan from the left side this time, and he goes to the bank once more.
How confident is that? He steps out there, shoots that basketball, posts up. Complete player, especially on that offensive end.
7-footer with a feathery touch. Johnson again to the left hand, and again with the 2 points.
And Tim Duncan's upset at himself now. Bob, this is a first-team all-league defender, and he knows one of the keys is to keep Larry Johnson down point-wise. He does not want to let him get off here tonight.
Clock ticking down toward 4 minutes. Knicks by 2. Mario Elie tried to return it to Duncan. Ball swatted away. Houston looking to save it. Elie had to hoist it up there to beat the 24-second clock. But it's a violation anyway, as the ball didn't hit the rim.
When you talk about the Spurs, they need time on the shot clock to run their offense because they're not a team that breaks you down off the dribble. So if they have to use clock, that's when they get themselves in trouble. That's why the Knicks point guards really need to pressure them.
They start the offense again with Houston out on the right side. He gets a screen and pops a 3. It's long and the rebound is taken by Robinson. Avery Johnson trying to find Duncan. It's broken up. And it's Nick Ball as Sprewell snatches it. Sprewell stutter-stepping against Elliott. Now it's in Houston's hands. Thomas sets the screen for him. Gets it back. And connects.
Remember in game one, now he had 13 points and 16 rebounds. Since then, he has not had a good game. So if they can get him involved in the offense, that could also be very critical.
How often have you heard a junior high or high school coach say this? The man who sets the screen gets the shot. That time, Thomas did.
Well, as I talked about in the open, the importance of Larry Johnson scoring for the New York Knicks. So they run the last two plays for him, and even though he's undersized, he's going to try to get that ball to the rim. Gets in the paint, and you see David Robinson and Duncan both converge on him. The kind little bounce here off the rim, and then the next possession, they go back to him once again, this time with a nice roll with the left-hand hook shot as he goes into the paint over Tim Duncan. And it's going to be important again for him to score, because when he scores, you see game three, Bobby had 16. That's the win. In the other games, he averaged 5 points. So they need him to score. In that timeout, Jeff Van Gundy says, looks like you're tired. Do you want to come out? He said, no. Let me play.
Jaren Jackson is in. Mario Elie out. David Robinson to the bench. Malik Rose in. And a nicely executed play with Tim Duncan picking up the assist on an Avery Johnson basket.
Well, that's the first basket from the supporting cast that we talked about in our open. They're now 1-for-7.
Allen Houston with the jumper. Good again.
Now, if you run a clinic, you take that right there and you show it to young people. The pivot. Allen did everything with the pivot that time. The ball never touched the floor, created space, and shot the jump shot.
Jaren Jackson, just 2-for-15 since a big game one. Duncan against Thomas. His moves in the post are so much more polished than you'd expect from any player, really, let alone a second-year player.
Remember now, he was well-taught at Wake Forest and stayed there for 4 years, so that has really helped him be such a quality player so early in his career.
Footwork is wonderful.
Absolutely.
Sprewell into Thomas. Kurt Thomas in a crowd, knocked away from him, but a foul. It's the foul-prone Malik Rose, who always plays hard but often hears the whistle.
Bob, we talk about so often that the Spurs offense is going to go through Duncan and Robinson. This time, the little soft pass in the lane as he throws it right over Avery, over Charlie Ward's shoulder. This time, the single coverage, he gets himself deep. Watch how he spins there with that footwork. Great extension on that little jump hook. Tim Duncan.
Thomas hit the first free throw. Larry Johnson going out and Chris Dudley in.
Well, let's keep our eye on this now. They've got themselves a three-point lead here as Kurt Thomas shoots it to make it 4. Dudley comes in. Larry Johnson gets a little rest. A minute 58 to go. Let's see what happens here in about this last 2 minutes.
Duncan, Dudley on him. Avery, back to Duncan, head of the key from 20. That one's long, and the rebound belongs to Dudley. Houston to the drive. Hit the side of the glass with it. He has it back. Sprewell's open. Will take the three. Instead, drives and hits.
The pace of this game favors New York. Bob, San Antonio had 27 points at the end of the first quarter. Tonight, only 15.
Joe Crawford says hold on as the Knicks have established their biggest lead at 6. Chris Dudley hit with his first foul. That'll bring Duncan to the line where he's hit 80% in this series.
That last possession on the offensive rebound, they kick the ball out to Sprewell. You're saying, I want to close out on this guy, make him shoot a three. You think you've closed out well, and he just blows by you and gets to the basket. Just a little crack of daylight's all he needs.
Allen Houston to Sprewell. Sprewell's little fadeaway is short. Jaren Jackson has the rebound. Here is Jackson, hitting a three.
Uh-oh. Bob, you nicknamed him the Eliminator in the Los Angeles series after his games 3 and 4, and I know Jeff Van Gundy does not want to see this guy get hot.
And he's been anything but hot since game one. Ward, little floater. He had 10 points in the first quarter of game 4. That's his first basket of game 5. Last half minute. Duncan over Dudley. Can't hit the bank. Houston's got it. Game clock and shot clock virtually identical.
Now, they love to isolate up at the top, allow Allen Houston to go one-on-one. If anybody helps, they'll penetrate for the jump shot, but Houston's going to try to get his own score here.
Everybody up at the Garden. 5 seconds. Houston, off the dribble, leans in, beats the buzzer, but doesn't get the bounce.
Now, Allen Houston is very, very upset. He felt like he got fouled. All right, Bob, we'll show you why there was no foul call here on Sean Elliott. Now, watch this line, and now who breaks this plane right here of verticality? Elliott or Houston? Who jumps in and creates the contact? You can see right there that it's Allen Houston. That's why there was no call made on that play. So there's going to be contact, but the referee says, who created the contact? Did the offensive man jump in? Did he give the defender a chance to go up? And that's more animation than you've seen on Allen Houston. Very upset. That would have been critical. If he got fouled or two free throws, they would have been up five. Now going into the second quarter, as it is, only three.
Chris Childs and Charlie Ward are now on the floor together. Steve Kerr is in for San Antonio. Ward to Thomas, and now Childs behind Thomas's screen. Childs is now 4-for-19 in the series.
Well, they need Childs because Charlie Ward wore down the other night with too many minutes after the great first half. He was 0-for-5 in the second. They need Childs.
Childs played only 7 minutes on the bum knee in game four. Duncan, close to unstoppable. You can maybe make him take a more difficult shot, but you can almost never stop him from getting it off.
Now watch this team right now for New York. They have two guys out there, Ward and Dudley, that they're not going to guard, so they're playing about 3-on-5 round. Actually, Childs, too, so a very poor offensive team right now for the Knicks.
Kurt Thomas. Sean Elliott takes the rebound.
How much time can Jeff Van Gundy buy before he has to come back with Larry Johnson or Houston?
Here's Steve Kerr. Ward up on him. Kerr will let fly from the head of the key, and it's way off. Thomas up on the glass. Sprewell, baseline drive. He was fouled. It could have been a three-point play. As it is, he'll shoot two.
Larry Johnson will come back into the ball game right now and take out Chris Dudley. And I'm sure Dudley's not happy, but right now they can ill afford to have guys out there on the floor that can score, that cannot score. Actually, I guess Dudley's going to stay. He's bringing Charlie Ward out of the game. Bob, when you try to cut that baseline off on Sprewell, you better get a foot out of bounds. That guy is so quick. The only other guy I've seen all year long that uses that baseline like him is Kobe Bryant. For New York.
And in comparing Sprewell to Kobe Bryant, you're talking about two guys whose first step is as quick as an eye blink.
That's true.
Foul a moment ago was on Duncan, his first. And Jackson lost it with Sprewell hounding him.
Ball pressure, really an unforced error that time. Jaren Jackson, not a good passer, and Popovich knows that, but he wants him to be able to enter the ball in the post, so if they double, they can kick it back to him as a shooter.
Turnovers, San Antonio 5, Knicks 1. Larry Johnson working on Duncan, fadeaway. Made him take a very tough shot, and he couldn't hit it. Duncan had it knocked away. No foul on the last play, just Spurs ball out of bounds after it was touched last by New York. Here's Duncan leaning in, and it spins out for him. The rebound is taken by Thomas. Houston's back in. Sprewell's out. Thomas against Malik Rose. Hits over him.
So that's what they're going to do, Bob. Anytime that they take out either Duncan or Robinson, they're going to try to post that man up. And Malik Rose does not have the size to play against Kurt Thomas.
As he starts his drive, there's a foul on the play. It's on Larry Johnson, his second. Duncan out, Robinson in. Consider the frustration of Larry Johnson. He's got to try to guard one of the Twin Towers more often than not. And then one of them is usually guarding him. But if Patrick Ewing were available, that wouldn't be the case.
No question. It would change the matchups entirely. He would then match up against probably Sean Elliott.
Malik Rose with a jump hook. Gets the back iron with it. It'll be New York ball. The Spurs have so little regard for Chris Dudley's offense that they have the 6'5 Mario Elie guarding him. So they go to Dudley. Up top, Johnson for three. And Kerr grabs the rebound.
Now 2 of 16 of three. Dudley that time with the double team. Larry Johnson just cannot find the range on that outside jumper that was so good to him against Indiana.
Robinson, two defenders. Misses over them. Houston back. Thomas outside to Childs. Now Johnson. Left hand, got it off the glass.
Larry Johnson can have success against Malik Rose. They're very, very similar players. About the same size. He knows he's not a shot blocker.
It's that 2 for 16 from three that's killing him, because that's what's available for him more than any other shot against the Twin Towers in this series. Except in the rare circumstance when, as you said, a Malik Rose is on him.
See, Duncan is double-teaming off of him. That's why he's getting that three-point shot.
Robinson's jumper is short. Allen Houston around Kerr to the basket. The Knicks open up an 8-point lead. They're on a 7-0 run, and the Spurs stop the clock.
New York leads by 8, 7:37 to go in the second quarter. You take a look at the scoring. Houston's pretty well. Larry Johnson shipping in tonight, and Thomas. But you see Duncan is 4 of 9. The rest of the Spurs, 4 of 16. And Sean Elliott and Mario Elie, 0 of 4 for only 2 points. From these two guys combined for 32 points in game four.
Offensive foul against San Antonio. It's Malik Rose's second.
Duncan gets a little bit of a rest, and Greg Popovich says, we do not want to dig ourselves a hole, so he comes right back. But remember, here's a guy who played 47 minutes in a couple playoff games, so he's used to going the entire way. Robinson's the guy they got to keep their eye on and get him the ample rest.
Sean Elliott also back with Jaren Jackson out. And this time the call goes the other way. Offensive foul on the Knicks. It's Chris Childs, and it's his first. Childs giving Johnson a bit of trouble as he brings it out of the backcourt.
So this is the pressure that New York wants right here. They want that clock burning down against them. Right now it's 10 and they still haven't gotten into anything.
But Duncan can take care of a lot of lapses.
That's not a bad option, is it, Bob? When in doubt, give it to Tim Duncan.
Houston. Tough luck on the shot. Johnson spinning, dumping it off for Robinson, but an offensive foul.
One thing New York has done very well tonight, they've kept Avery Johnson out of the lane. Remember all the havoc that he wreaked in game four, Bobby. He had 14 points, more importantly, 10 assists. When he got in there, it opened up the offensive boards. Tonight, that is not happening. And one thing that New York has got to stay away from, those scoring droughts that gets themselves in trouble.
Houston.
When in doubt, go to Allen Houston.
He's got 10.
He's really getting so good in that low post area. Something he's added to his game.
Elie into Duncan. Back to Avery Johnson. Left unattended. And misses from 20. Rebound back tapped, and Elliott has it. Duncan slings it cross-court to Elliott. Touch pass inside to Robinson against Dudley. Jump hook. Good.
That was good defense. That was just better offense by David Robinson. Dudley was right there.
Oh. Houston starts his move on Elliott. And Joe Crawford spots a foul.
Very good ball movement this time by San Antonio. The ball went side to side, and then it goes inside to David Robinson. They're not going to double team him. Dudley's got him straight up. He wheels in there with that left hand and really just gets the kind roll. But if Dudley can force him to take those kind of shots, he'll be okay.
Foul was Elliott's second. Kurt Thomas misses the open jumper. Robinson another rebound. Duncan with Thomas on him. Little fadeaway jumper is good.
Now that was a powerful move that time by Duncan. He actually got banged and he was able to continue on through and finish that shot. San Antonio back within four.
And 14 for Duncan. Chris Childs catch and shoot.
All created out of the double team on Allen Houston. Duncan's going back to double the post. San Antonio does not like to do that. It gets him too spread out on the floor.
Robinson battling with Thomas. Hold on, says Steve Javich. That'll be number two on Thomas. Let's check with Jim Gray.
All right, thanks, Bob. As Marcus Camby comes back out on the court, Jeff Van Gundy walked over to him as he was waiting to come back in. He said, play aggressive. None of these little touch fouls. If you're going to create contact, make sure it's a good foul. Let's not pick up your third on anything cheap. Bob?
Sprewell back in for New York as well. Thanks, Jim. Mario Elie. With the bounce to Robinson, Camby pokes it away, and Houston takes it. Knicks with numbers. Houston the lob for Sprewell, but they can't quite finish it. Robinson got inside, and all Houston could do was grab him.
This place would have really gone crazy had this play gone through. Allen Houston, a great pass. And Sprewell just a little bit out of his reach where he couldn't quite get a handle on it and finish it. That would have given him an 8-point lead. But what happens now? Spurs run right back and post Robinson. Allen Houston has to take the foul.
Mario Elie on the move. Left hand. He was fouled.
Question is it Camby? That will be his third. Let's see who they call this on.
It's on Houston. His second. Two quick ones, though, in the last 10 seconds or so on Allen. Tomorrow on NBA Inside Stuff, Ahmad Rashad sits down with the Spurs' Tim Duncan. Let's throw it over to Ahmad and find out more.
Well, Bob, I found out that Tim Duncan is a very, very funny guy. Doesn't look like when he's playing basketball, he's so serious, but off the court has a lot of fun. Also has a pretty good bank shot, I found out about. So you can find out a lot more if you watch Inside Stuff tomorrow, Bob.
Ahmad, thanks. Mario Elie hits them both. And the Spurs are back to within four. Childs has it back. Now Houston, six on the 24. It'll be Camby, and it'll be New York by six.
Houston is just creating shots for everybody. Out of the double team, out of the penetrating drives, he gets his own.
Duncan. Bennett Salvatore waves it off. He traveled. The Spurs turned the ball over 20 times in the course of losing game three. Survived 17 turnovers to win game four. Tonight, they've given it up 9 times to New York's 2 already. Sprewell, tough shot with a hand in his face, and it won't go. Robinson outlets to Avery Johnson. Duncan. How do you stop him?
Well, you don't. You got to hope that maybe somebody can get over and get a hand up. But, Bob, as we talked about before, when this game is over, Duncan and Robinson, you can put it in the book, are going to have 40 to 50 points. It's what their teammates do that's going to decide whether or not they can get the win tonight.
Let's look at what the Twin Towers have done through the series and to this point in Game 5. 23 points and 13 rebounds between them in this game. They combined for the monster 35 rebounds 18 for Duncan and 17 for Robinson in game four. And between them, they have 13, 7 for the Admirals, 6 for Duncan in game five. Pass for Johnson. Knicks lose it. 2.5 minutes remaining in the first half. Spurs can close to within two if they hit a basket here. Robinson returns it to Johnson. Now here's Elliott. Can be taken by Johnson, who beats the shot clock and hits.
Well, that's tough luck there for New York. Great defense. The ball's knocked over, loose ball, and Avery Johnson picked up. And through all this now, the Spurs are hanging around, down only two now, going inside 2 minutes of the half.
Houston. The rebound to Duncan, and San Antonio looks to tie.
Bob, the one thing here, they're going to try to go to David Robinson against Camby. He cannot pick up his third foul.
Coming in front for the steal is Spreewell. He's gone. Boy, will he play those passing lanes.
Oh, Bob, how fast he closes the distance between that pass. You try to make that pass over 20 feet, he's going to shoot the gap and get the score.
And Avery Johnson wisely didn't even try to catch up to foul him. He just let him go. Now it's Spreewell again, but this time he got a piece of Robinson for the foul.
See what's happened? He's not playing Sean Elliott. That's why Elliott has to be aggressive on defense. He's just playing the passing lanes, running off Sean Elliott. That time he steps in front of him. But Bob, on this last play, as you see with this great finish, on the last play, Sean Elliott is in the corner. He's all the way down in the corner. He's just not even playing Sean Elliott. He's just playing the passing lane. And they call the foul on Spreewell, and Robinson will go to the line. But remember we talked about before game four how Sean Elliott has to be aggressive? Spreewell has got to burn some energy on the defensive end, and right now he's just playing free safety.
The foul was Spree's first. Robinson hit the first. But not the second. So New York's lead is 3. Childs spinning around Antonio Daniels, who's just come in, but then the pass goes astray, and the Spurs will have it.
So you got to be careful there. They're going to push you on that baseline, and if you're not big enough to finish, you're driving yourself into a turnover. The supporting cast has been shut down. You see the numbers there, 3 for 6, 9, 3 for 10 from those players. And that's what New York is counting on. Do the job on Robinson and Duncan, make them work hard, take everybody else out of the game tonight. They're up 3.
San Antonio took their 22nd timeout to set up their plan for the last minute. Antonio Daniels hit some big shots in game 3 that didn't play in game 4. It's Robinson leaning in and spinning it home.
Camby's got to stay on his feet. If he gets up in the air, that's where you get that third foul, because Robinson's going to jump into you.
The Knicks now expend their 20.
See, now Camby's got 2. Bobby played 3.5 minutes before he picked up those 2 fouls. Laying behind Robinson, look at him leave his feet and allow Robinson to just waltz in for that little layup. What you have to do is stay big and make him shoot a jump shot over the top of you. And you can see in the playoffs as he's gone along, he had a great series against Portland. Defensively, he was terrific to help Shaq. And in this series, you see he's doing well, 17 points and almost 12 rebounds. And in the wins, they've blocked at least 7 shots combined, he and Tim Duncan.
10-8 to this point for Robinson.
See, I think this last 45 seconds is going to be so important for New York. They've really outplayed San Antonio up to this point in time. And if San Antonio gets a stop here and goes in with the lead, that could be a little bit disheartening for New York.
Dudley, Spreewell, Houston, Camby, and Childs for New York. Duncan, Robinson, Elliott, Jaren Jackson, and Antonio Daniels for San Antonio. Spreewell against Elliott. His pass knocked away by Robinson. Still Nick Ball. 10 on the shot clock. 34.2 on the game clock.
Watch Spreewell sneaking down the lane here. He looks for that little quick pass.
Instead, it goes into Houston. He pulls up and fires. The rebound is grabbed by Antonio Daniels. Daniels on the move. Contact. Ball not free. Childs almost stole it. San Antonio has it. 9 seconds to shoot.
If I'm Jeff Van Gundy, I get Camby out of it right now so he does not pick up his third foul. See if he gets Camby out, because Camby will get his third foul. And you got to get him out and protect him, because four fouls in the second half is a lot better than two. This is a great substitution here by Jeff Van Gundy.
And here comes the oldest player in the NBA, 41-year-old Herb Williams, 4 years older than his coach. He was a star at Ohio State during the Carter administration. Popular here at the Garden. The applause is for him. Here's Jaren Jackson. Fires the three and hits it, and San Antonio, with 6 seconds remaining, takes a two-point lead. Sprewell hurrying back. Has to let it go. Someone got a piece of it, and that's the way the first half ends, with the Knicks, who led by as many as eight, now trailing by two. Bob Costas back along with Doug Collins. Third quarter about to start. Quick thought on the outlook here in the second half.
New York has to score. Remember, Bob, game four, they got outscored 9-0, went from 4 to 13. They never recovered from that. They want to play from ahead, and you can see they led almost 20 minutes of that first half. That little drought in the last 7.5 minutes, the 8-point lead to the 2-point deficit. They've got to score. They've got to come out here and have offensive efficiency.
In addition to the Jaren Jackson three with 6 seconds to go in the half that you heard Jeff Van Gundy lamenting, another big play came late in the half with the shot clock winding down. Ball swatted away and right into the hands of Avery Johnson, who hit one from the right side just as the shot clock was about to expire. Nick Ball trailing by a basket. Latrell Sprewell, Camby screening for him. Sprewell blows by Robinson, who catches up and blocks it from behind. Elliott from Duncan returns it to him. His turnaround, Larry Johnson got a piece of that. Mario Elie hits the deck, but the call is going to go against San Antonio, and it's Elie's second.
Sprewell goes to the basket. You see Duncan and Robinson both get a piece. That's really the Spurs' first block shot of the game, which is amazing. And then Larry Johnson blocks one down on the other end of Duncan. That's their third block.
And New York turns it over. Robinson to that hook, but it comes up short.
Bobby, we've had four possessions. Neither team's hit the rim yet here to start this third period. Make it five.
A New York turnover as Robinson steals it. Duncan can't put a stop to it. Houston, crossover. Deals it out to Sprewell, and there's a whistle before Spree's shot. It's foul number three on Sean Elliott as the second half starts in ragged fashion.
Well, see, if you're in New York, the one thing you don't want to do is burn up a lot of energy here and get nothing accomplished. You've got to be able to put some points on the board. Jaren Jackson now is going to step in for Sean Elliott. Remember now, here's a guy who hit 2 for 2 from the three-point line at 6 points off the bench. Ellie and Elliott combined for nothing.
Johnson, Duncan on him, fakes the jumper, goes to the drive, misses with the left hand, and Robinson is there to clear it. Avery Johnson bounces to the driving Jaren Jackson, and San Antonio has the first points of the half.
How often have we seen that? Ellie and Elliott 0 for 5 in the first half. They do 4 for 4 from the free throw line. Now Jaren Jackson with 8 points. It's like timely shooting by somebody all playoffs.
Charlie Ward into the lane. Running one-hander, spins out. Duncan rebounds, outlets to Avery Johnson. Cut off by Allen Houston. Jaren Jackson hoists up a three, and suddenly he's hot again.
There's the same start that we saw in the third quarter. Now, the game has gone from 2-7, and Jeff Van Gundy's got to be very, very upset. Their offensive efficiency has been awful. But more importantly, Jaren Jackson, they've not gotten back to him. You see the animation there on Jeff Van Gundy, very upset. How can you leave Jaren Jackson? Jaren Jackson runs the floor, lays the ball in the basket, and this guy's sort of their wild card. If he's shooting the ball well, fine. If he's not, they take him out of the game. And here it is once again, Bob, the kick out. Allen Houston way too far away from him in no position to help. And he buries a three. So five quick points here from Jaren Jackson.
In fact, their last eight dating back to right. The end of the second quarter for the eliminator.
So that's right. And you see there, 23-8 run. And remember, we talked about the droughts of New York. They just don't have enough firepower to fight through these periods of time.
Here is Sprewell. Jackson jockeying back and forth as he tries to defend him. Charlie Ward now on the drive. Back outside to Spree. He gets into the lane but doesn't take the ball with him. San Antonio on the run. Here's Mario Elie, and he's clobbered by Larry Johnson. That's three on Johnson.
San Antonio is a tremendous defensive team, and they chase you off shots, and they run you into shot blocking. And that's what's happened right now. And Jeff Van Gundy with a very concerned look on his face. Because, Bob, in the open, we said one of the things they're going to have to do is score. Figure out this San Antonio defense. And right now they're putting a hammer down on them.
Mario Elie. Named, and this is true, for the opera singer Mario Lanza. And the whole tenor of this game has changed as the Spurs have now scored 13 unanswered points dating back to the second quarter.
Now a 9-0 run, identical to game four. So bad start here by New York.
Johnson. The block will be on San Antonio. Stopping the clock with 8:50 to play in the third, and the Knicks still scoreless in this period. David Robinson with his first foul. After 3 minutes and 10 seconds of the third, the Knicks have scored.
Well, Bob, I'm looking here at Jaren Jackson. I'm thinking, this is a great guy you want to have on your team. When you've played for eight teams in the league and been kicked around, missing a few jump shots is not going to keep you from shooting the basketball. And tonight, he's sort of been the difference in this game right now as they've taken the lead.
And here's Charlie Ward sneaking in and poking it away from Duncan. So the Knicks have it back. Houston hits the three and misses it. Duncan out to Avery Johnson. Jaren Jackson. Elie and Robinson playing a two-man game. The Admiral with the hook. And Ward with the rebound. Here's Houston to the hoop for the first field goal for the Knicks.
See, New York will be able to score if they can stop them and run. Bob, remember, they made their last six shots of the first half. When you're taking the ball out of the basket, you can't run. The defense is back.
Duncan out high, 5 on the 24. 3 seconds to shoot. They swing it to the side for Jackson. And a shot clock violation. He wanted the foul. The shot wound up being an air ball. And the Knicks get it back.
Again, New York has got to find a way to score. They've got to come down, attack this defense, see if Allen Houston can make something happen here.
Larry Johnson out to Sprewell. Johnson has it back, spinning on Duncan. Houston. It's a two. He wasn't quite behind the line. A tough, tough shot brings the Knicks to within four. And now San Antonio wants time. After the timeout, Spurs up four. Knicks have scored five unanswered points. Here's Duncan. Ball squirts free. Duncan reclaims it. 5 seconds to shoot. Avery Johnson leans in, but can't hit. Sneaking in for the steal, though, is Mario Elie. Jackson feeling it. Misses the three this time. Sprewell with the rebound. Charlie Ward looking for Houston, who's been hot.
Stepped out of bounds.
He was on the sideline before the shot.
Wow, we got to remember that. That would have made it a one-point game. Allen Houston, watch his back foot now as he tries to gather himself. This is what happens a lot of times on that sideline. You step out, that would have made it a one-point game. Keep our eye on this little swing here.
Jaren Jackson on the drive. And he traveled.
He got caught in the air, and he wanted to pass it, but his feet came down on the floor before he got rid of the basketball, and that was caused because Marcus Camby came over to challenge his shot. Watch his feet now as he goes in the air, and watch his feet. They'll hit the floor, then he tries to pass it. Too late. Traveling violation.
Johnson to Camby. Marcus Camby missing on the run. Duncan will take it. And a shot clock violation.
See, this is one of the rules I'd like to see change. Duncan had possession of that ball. I would like to see him just play on. Rather be a 24-second violation. The Spurs have it. Just keep playing. No need to stop it there.
Ball didn't draw iron,
absolutely.
So technically a 24-second
right.
violation. Houston knocks it away from Elie. Spurs ball, 8 on the 24.
Well, Tim Duncan very upset there on that roll. He wanted Jackson to throw that ball high to the rim, and he let him know, get that ball up there. Larry Johnson can't defend me.
Jaren Jackson out to Avery Johnson. 3 seconds to shoot. Avery has it stripped away by Charlie Ward. Here come the Knicks. Sprewell with four.
Finish, and again it's done off a steal. That's 5 turnovers now for Avery Johnson in the ball game, and Latrell Sprewell just ignites this crowd. He takes off the powerful finish. See, those big guys aren't back on defense, Bob. When you can get out and run like that, you keep those shot blockers out of the game. New York needs more of that.
3-point play, 1-point game. Foul was on Jaren Jackson, his first.
Boy, just about the time it looks like New York's going to be knocked out of it, they fight back. We've seen this the entire series.
8 straight Knickerbocker points. Duncan can't put a stop to it. The rebound to Sprewell. Weaving his way through a whole pack of Spurs and finally giving it up to Ward, but not for long.
San Antonio playing a half-court game.
10-0 New York run. Mario Elie sets on three and a big one for San Antonio.
Wow, that cries the crowd right there. Goes from now a 1-point deficit up to Mario Elie. We've seen him do that so very often in playoffs. Big shots when he was with Houston and they won championships.
Houston shoots on the rebound. Can't tie it. Robinson got good position but couldn't score. Sprewell, who seems to be everywhere, grabs the rebound, brings it up, pops the shot.
challenging every shot in the low post.
50-50, and San Antonio loses it. Here comes Charlie Ward, all the way. Knicks have the lead. Jaren Jackson looking for Tim Duncan. Duncan out to Ellie. Set shot. Short. Bounces back to him. I'll tell you one thing. Where they place the 24-second clock, I can't see it.
I was going to say the same thing.
It's out of our view. Here's Duncan stumbling to the floor. Might have been tripped. Apparently he was. Robinson out of the double to Jackson, who's feeling it, but not this time. Line drive rebound taken on a hop by Houston. He leads Sprewell. Back to Houston, around Elliott. Here's his jumper going. Allen Houston has 16. Duncan double team, scores anyway, plus the foul.
Allen Houston is doing a wonderful job. This little pull-up jump shot, we've seen it the entire series. Realizes one more dribble, he gets himself in trouble because David Robinson is standing there. And Bob, in this last possession, when Tim Duncan scored, he and Robinson were 0 for 6 in this quarter. So that's his first field goal. His and Robinson's first 3 points of the quarter. They now trail by one.
3-point play after Kurt Thomas's third foul. Inside 2 minutes to play in the third. Latrell Sprewell. They had him surrounded. He scored anyway.
Well, he's one of those guys, it doesn't matter. You could put two guys on him. When he starts to get this kind of energetic run, you just got to hope that he cools off.
He's got 19, nine of them in this period.
So look at that clock get down against him right now. This is where San Antonio gets themselves in trouble. Starts standing around.
5 seconds to shoot. Duncan will. And he banks it home from long range.
I guess you can stand around, but when you got that guy, he sort of erases any kind of trouble you get yourself into. 5 straight points by Duncan now.
Here's Houston into the lane, but he travels. It is not fair or accurate to compare anyone to Michael Jordan, but remember how, when the Bulls' offense, sophisticated as it was, bogged down, you could always just go to Michael. That's sort of the case here.
But what Kurt Thomas has got to do with that clock wound down, he's got to make him put that ball on the floor. That's his shot. Now he's got to crowd him. There you go. Now get help from the weak side.
But don't foul him.
That's right.
Duncan has shot free throws extremely well in this final.
Well, you see the first time in the finals. It was Michael's seventh season. He averaged a little over 31. It's Duncan's second. He's averaging a little over 26. So these guys obviously are the main men. And once again, Spurs have taken the advantage by one. Bob, I think with all the run and everything that New York has done, they need to give a lead here going into this fourth period.
23 for Duncan. San Antonio by one. Sprewell gets his man off his feet and scores again. Sprewell is 5 for 5 in this quarter. Sean Elliott deals to Malik Rose, and there's a New York foul. If it's Thomas, it's his fifth, and it is.
What's this up and under fake here by Sprewell? He's been hitting every shot. Sean Elliott becomes a member of the paratrooper club there when he tries to go for that block. And Sprewell says, I'm not there anymore. I'm going to hit the little jumper.
Thomas out with the 5 fouls. Chris Dudley back. and Rose misses. Kurt Thomas, who had been a demon on the boards through the first three games, had only two rebounds in 19 minutes of game four, has three rebounds and five fouls in 19 minutes to this point in game five.
Well, they need him out there because he can make that little medium-range jump shot. And we know Dudley's a good defender, but he struggles on the offensive end.
Tie game at 58.
Now, the reason Antonio Daniels is in the game and not Steve Kerr is because with all the pressure in the backcourt, he's their second-best ball handler, and he can get them into their offense. Kerr cannot do that.
Sprewell, scorching hot. Doesn't stay that way. Dudley rebounds, but before he can put it back in, a loose ball foul on him. His second.
You know, most guys who expend this kind of energy in this kind of quarter with Sprewell, you think fatigue could be a factor. Bob, this guy, fatigue is not going to be a factor as Dudley gets the push in the back. But this guy's not even breathing. I mean, he says, get me the ball. We got 10 seconds to go. I'll get us another basket here when we go in this fourth period. Chris Dudley's going to come over the back here. Watch his left arm there. That's a little bit of a touch foul. And
oh,
a nice
that's not
little,
much.
No, and it's a, but, you know, a nice acting job there for Duncan. It's only taken his second year to realize that he's a star. Flop a little bit. Maybe he'll get that call.
No wonder Van Gundy had that pained expression on his face. Second one spills off. Spurs by one. Last 4 seconds. Houston gets into the lane. Deals it out to Camby. Beats the buzzer, but misses. A one-point game and 12 minutes to decide it. Familiar faces among the 19,763 at the Garden include Tim Hutton, Soon Yi and Woody. They're regulars. Matt Dillon is here. Rick Moranis on hand. He was part of the championship teams in 70 and 73. Bill Bradley. Billy Crystal here as always. A bevy of Bills. Billy Baldwin is here. And the always understated Macho Camacho, tastefully attired Matthew Modine, cheering the Knicks on. San Antonio up by one and with the ball now. Jaren Jackson, little double pump attempt that's no good. Houston has it. Both corner clocks are on now. Here's Sprewell on his game, but Duncan gets there to block it. Spree tried to save it, but into Rose's hands. Back comes San Antonio. Antonio Daniels getting some minutes now at the start of the fourth. The clocks above each basket are off, and the corner clocks, which have been rolled onto the floor, are on. Duncan spins and hits off the glass. He's almost too good.
How good is that? The spin off the glass looks like he didn't know where he was, but if I am New York right now with David Robinson out of the game, I get that ball out of Duncan's hands. You can't let him beat you right now. Make somebody else shoot the ball.
26 for Duncan, just about his finals average. And a San Antonio foul.
But what I'm talking about, he's isolated right here. Run somebody in from behind him. You know he's going to spin. New York is too late getting there. Sprewell, and look at that shot. One-handed off the glass to give the Spurs a three-point lead. New York, offensive efficiency vital here in this fourth quarter. No empty trips.
Sprewell lays it in.
See, Sean Elliott has not been a part of their offense tonight, and as a result, defensively, Sprewell is just going at him. He's alive with energy. Sean Elliott, they need him in this fourth quarter.
Yeah, Elliott's next basket will be his first. Duncan looking for Elliott, but it's off his hands. And Larry Johnson takes it. Sprewell gets the next to lane and he'll come to the line.
You never want to foul a jump shooter. Sprewell, this that's the shot you want him to take right here, the little pull-up. Malik Rose hits him on the wrist to follow through in the three-point play. Avery Johnson's going to come back into the ball game because they need to be able to get into their offense. How much more time can Popovich buy before he brings David Robinson back in the game? He's been a good rest right now into the third quarter to start the fourth. New York back up by two.
Sprewell with 26, matching Duncan's total. Duncan has scored 10 of the Spurs' last 11 points.
Well, they got to be careful, Bob, not to have him do it all right now. If he needs some help.
Or does he?
Wow. Wow. See, I still think as much as Jeff Van Gundy doesn't want a double team right now, you've got to get Duncan out of his game and make Antonio Daniels or somebody make a shot.
Sprewell, double-teamed, illegal defense. New York's Twin Towers in the nighttime sky. San Antonio's Twin Towers inside the Garden have combined for 38 points, 18 rebounds, 2 blocks.
David Robinson back after a nice little rest. More importantly, only 3.5 game minutes, but got almost a 15-minute rest. He'll be fresh for the finish.
Here's Houston. Duncan is on him. 10 seconds to shoot. Allen Houston misses on the run. LA with the rebound. San Antonio looking to snap the tie. Robinson just back in. Tim Duncan from beyond the head of the key. This time he can't get it done.
Knicks need to keep running. They don't want to set up right now. That'll play into San Antonio's hands. Get something quickly.
Sprewell. When you feel it, why not? He's not really a three-point shooter, but tonight, anything goes.
Bob, if you touched him right now, he would shock you. All the electricity running through this guy's body right now tonight. He has been absolutely tremendous. 29 points, 8 of 12 free throws, 9 rebounds, and 2 steals for Latrell Sprewell.
There are 10 players on the floor, but for the last several minutes, it's been Sprewell and Duncan. Spree with the last 12 Knick points, Duncan with 12 of the Spurs' last 13, and a foul on Chris Dudley, his third.
Which man is going to get some help, though, Bob, because you know eventually somebody else is going to have to come through. Who's going to be the wild card? Will it be Houston, Robinson? Who will it be?
Duncan. Again, and the same result.
See, he's getting so deep in that post. I think Jeff Van Gundy is going to have to give a little help. That's too easy there.
30 points now for Tim Duncan. Houston to Sprewell. Turns, pops, hits.
You know what this reminds me of? Game 7 of the Eastern Conference Finals. Larry Bird and yep. Dominique Wilkins. Who missed first? Dominique and Bird won. What a game that was.
One of the great duels in the history of the NBA. Knicks by 3. Sean Elliott. Avery Johnson on the move. The thunder is good. First Spur other than Duncan to score in a long time. And again, a one-point game. Looking for the hot hand. He brings it outside, intended for Johnson. Robinson, with the great agility for a big man, steals it. Duncan inside to Robinson, blocked by Dudley, but a foul. And that'll be 4 on Dudley.
David Robinson in the passing lane. It's not bad. 7-foot guy who can get in the lane to steal the ball. See, David's sort of hobbling, still not warmed up after he'd gotten sitting down on the bench for a while. But see, when you trap that screen, what Robinson's going to do is just post up right underneath the basket. And Duncan is such a good passer, he can find him there.
Talking about Robinson's agility, he actually was a gymnast for a while as a kid. And one time, Popovich let the Spurs out of practice when on a dare, Robinson walked on his hands from under the basket to midcourt. He makes 1 of 2, but they keep the ball alive, and the Spurs retain it.
No block out that time by Camby allowed Elliott to step in there, see if they can count up a basket here with this.
swatted away by Camby, who a year ago with the Raptors led the NBA in blocks per game, almost four a contest.
Bob, I still say the guy Sean Elliott has got to look for his shot. He's run off of it about three times now and passed the ball. He's got to look for his shot.
Here he is. Sprewell's on him. He takes a tough off-balance one-hander and misses it. Exactly 7 minutes left. Tied at 68. Illegal defense. And that's the second one on the Spurs. So the Knicks will shoot. Tonight, after the game and your late local news, the Tonight Show with Jay Leno. Included on the show, South Park creators Trey Parker and Matt Stone. Then it's Late Night with Conan O'Brien, Rob Schneider, and the music of Luscious Jackson. The Tonight Show and Late Night with Conan O'Brien later on NBC. Big miss by Houston. Still tied at 68. Has it knocked away by Avery Johnson into the hands of Sprewell, though, and they still have 10 seconds to shoot. Elliott diving after it, but a loose ball foul will be called on the Spurs, and it's Elliott's fourth.
And that's a big call. It looked like the ball was loose, and Sprewell and Elliott both were going for it. Avery Johnson was leaking out. It looked like he had a fast break. Wow, that's a tough. I don't know where that call came from, and neither does Avery Johnson. That's four fouls on Sean Elliott. He will sit down. Remember, Jaren Jackson's been the man with a hot hand. Allen Houston has got to stay attached to him, not let him get a free three.
Sprewell out of the double, finds Campbell.
Him step through this double team. He steps right through it as Duncan takes a bad angle, and then Avery Johnson on the weak side has got to be inside that man who's trying to cut to the basket. Well, this could be a big possession here. Remember, now it looked like Sean Elliott had the loose ball, the three-point play. So instead of San Antonio trying to take the lead, New York goes back up by three.
Can't be a three-point play after Avery Johnson's third foul. Knicks by three. Mario Elliott, 6 seconds to shoot. Avery Johnson, 3 seconds to shoot. Johnson with the running hook. And Larry Johnson takes the rebound. Camby missed it, and the rebound to Duncan.
Did you see on that last possession, Avery Johnson was looking around for the shot clock. He couldn't find it. He had to look at New York's end to try to find it.
Duncan has it poked away. Ball out of bounds, touched last by the Knicks. Through the thicket of bodies, he couldn't see the San Antonio shot clock in the corner. He looked all the way back the other way. You're right. They have 12 on the 24 now, and they ask for time.
Now coming out of that timeout, Jim Gray said, Jeff Van Gundy said, anybody but Duncan beat us.
Jaren Jackson is short with it. Robinson, though, on the offensive glass. And then he's fouled as he takes it to the rack. 3 on Camby.
Second shot. Tough shot by Jaren Jackson. David Robinson with the offensive rebound. Remember now, in game 4, he had 9 offensive rebounds, so he will go to the line to shoot 2.
If he hits the next, it's a 1-point game. 5:28 remaining. San Antonio is down to 2 timeouts. The Knicks have 4. Neither side has a 20 left. Jaren Jackson out. Sean Elliott quickly back in. 71-70. Sprewell out of the double to Johnson. Around the perimeter to Houston. Johnson again. Thought about a three. Instead drives the lane. Lays it up to Camby for the slam.
San Antonio was so concerned about Larry Johnson shooting a three, they ran at him and let him drive the ball to the basket. He found Camby.
Robinson goes to the right hand and goes to the line on top of it with a chance to tie the game.
Bob, Ahmad Rashad said to us, out of that timeout, Popovich said, go inside and don't give the ball up so quickly. Make them double team. You see, David Robinson had one thing on his mind, got away with a little jump step there in the three-point play opportunity as he got fouled. But look for them to continue to pound that ball inside until New York double teams and force them to give the ball up.
Can't complete the three-point play. The foul on Camby was his fourth. Knicks still with the one-point edge. And they want a timeout.
Welcome back to New York. The Knicks lead by one, 4:49 left. I'm Jim Gray. Jeff Van Gundy just told his team, mainly Marcus Camby, about defending David Robinson. Try to push him off his mark so he can't catch the ball that low. Then on offense, he wants them to have some patience. Don't just run down there and take the first shot. Take the best shot. For the Spurs, let's go to Ahmad Rashad.
All right, thanks, Jim. Greg Popovich, also his area of concern is the defense. Talking about the double team. When they come in double team, he wants them to get back quick because they end up one man short. Come to the double team, get back on your man quick, otherwise they leave somebody open. Bob?
Thanks, Jim and Ahmad. Here we go. Each team will be over the limit with its next foul. Sprewell, 5 seconds to shoot. Sprewell deals out to Johnson for three. Way off. Ellie chases it down.
Not even close on that shot. That's why I think you've got to close out quietly on him and make him continue to shoot that. Lost all confidence. Bob, 2 of 16 now in this series.
Mario Elie in the paint, but it's short. Sprewell, guarded by Elliott, fires over him.
Take. You don't want him to drive the ball to the basket. What a tough shot by Sprewell.
33 points. Duncan out of the double to Ellie. Tries to tie and does.
Going back to Sprewell in the post. A little cross screen here to try to get him the ball. Actually, Allen Houston breaks the play and takes it himself.
He's been quiet for a while, speaking of Houston. Sprewell with 8 on the shot clock. Johnson screening for him. It'll be Sprewell leaning in, drawing the contact. And the foul goes against Duncan. It's Tim's second.
Well, Duncan had done everything right that time except the last minute he reached in. And all he has to do is square him up and say, you know what, you're going to shoot the shot. But watch his hands. When you reach in right there, you're going to get the foul.
Sprewell with 34 points, 24 of them. Just as I was about to say, the graphics department's too quick. 24 in the second half. Childs all over Avery Johnson. Exactly 3 minutes left. 10 on the shot clock. Mario Elie. Houston hounding him. 5 seconds to shoot. Duncan unleashes a three. It's off, but Sprewell can't corral it, and the Spurs will set it up again. Just off Sprewell's fingertips. Duncan got low. It was rejected by Camby, but there's a foul.
See, they got the ball from side to side that time. They got the ball to the weak side, off the screen roll. And look how deep Duncan gets the ball in the post. When he gets it here, Larry Johnson's going to foul him. Camby comes over and blocks the shot, but too late.
And the foul on Johnson is his fifth. Duncan looks to tie it, but won't on this trip.
Now remember, one of the things in the regular season, Duncan and Robinson were both below 70% free throw shooters. So if you get into a foul shooting contest here late, you would have to favor New York.
1 point game. Between the rim and the glass, and that means a jump ball.
If you're going to go give help on Sprewell, you better get there quickly. He turns that corner, and look at Robinson and Duncan both there. Jump ball. Now, with that situation, you can choose who you want to jump. So it'll be David Robinson and Camby. Camby is very quick off his feet. See if he can tip that ball back to Chris Childs here.
It's Larry Johnson who grabs it. Knicks looking for breathing room, up by just one. Timeout, New York. 2 minutes and 5 seconds remaining.
2:05 left at Madison Square Garden. I'm Jim Gray. Jeff Van Gundy just told Latrell Sprewell, Latrell, the ball is coming to you. If there's something, go with it right away, but do not hold the ball. There is only 11 seconds left on the clock. Bob?
Each team with two timeouts remaining. No fouls to give for either side.
Allen Houston's only taken one shot in this fourth quarter. That's been a miss. They're laying right off of Childs and not letting him enter the ball to him.
Latrell around Duncan. Lost the handle for a moment. 3 seconds to shoot. They don't know it. Childs heaves it toward the hoop. Hits the side of the glass. And what a time for a 24-second violation.
See, when you get in a situation where you start holding that ball against the clock, that plays so much into what San Antonio wants to do. And you know they're coming down. It's either going to go to Duncan or Robinson. If they double team now, watch Elliott or Illy for a critical three-point shot attempt.
Mario Elie looking for Duncan. He has it against Johnson. They swing it around to Avery Johnson. The bounce to Robinson, in the lane, with the hook that's way off. A minute 25 remaining. Ten seconds to shoot.
Mismatch Sprewell in the post.
Back out to Johnson. Can he hit a three? He cannot. The Knicks have only 11 three-pointers in the entire series.
Minute to go, elimination game. Can New York hold them off?
Sean Elliott. Avery Johnson. Big hoop for Avery Johnson. The Spurs by one. Avery Johnson, undrafted. Bounced around the NBA, cut twice by the Spurs before sticking the third time. A 5'3" high school senior, the last man on his high school team, grew 8 inches in the next couple of years to get to 5'11".
And how often have we seen teams say, Avery Johnson, you have to make shots in the fourth quarter. In the entire playoff series, all the rounds, he's been able to do that. The double team, Sean Elliott looks like he wants to shoot it and doesn't take that shot. The hesitation. And then he finds Avery Johnson on the baseline, the rotation from New York. Once they came out of the double team, no one found Avery Johnson. And a critical possession now for New York. They're down one. But watch out of the double team. Now the ball is going to come to Sean Elliott. Latrell Sprewell goes back into the double team. And let's see what he does after he gets out of the double team. Here's Sprewell. And here is Avery Johnson right here. And let's see right now if they can find him out of the double team. Now watch Sprewell. He comes back across the floor. He gets confused. And in that little confusion, Avery Johnson spots up and gets the jump shot.
Left alone, Avery Johnson hit what may turn out to be the biggest basket of his long career. This is his 11th year in the NBA, 34 years old, out of Little Southern University. Doubted his entire career. One of his opponents, Damon Stoudemire, said only about a year ago, no team with Avery Johnson as its point guard will ever win the NBA championship. The Spurs are close, and if they do it along the way, Johnson outplayed and eliminated Stoudemire and the Trailblazers.
Well, you can see Latrell Sprewell's tried to do it by himself. No Allen Houston there. Only one attempt in this fourth period. And also, Allen Houston missed that little free throw there that would have, on the illegal defense, that would have made it a tie game right now. So you'd have the ball with a chance to go up rather than be on that odd point.
And what about the three that Houston swished, which was waved off because his heel was on the end line just before the release? All right, here we go. Childs to Sprewell. Dribble against Elliott. Let's it go. The scoring spree does not continue. And Avery Johnson, perhaps appropriately, has it.
Bob, I can't see the shot clock, but I think they're going to have to foul. I don't know how much disparity. It's about a three-second differential. They're taking a real chance here if they let this burn out.
It's David Robinson. Robinson spinning to the basket. Muscles up. No whistle. But he got it back. Now they have to come foul. They unleash the shot, and Johnson chases it down and calls a timeout with 1.4. The ball never got to the rim, I guess, and the 24-second clock continued to run.
Well, it hit the rim, Bob, as the shot clock had not gone off. So Avery Johnson's shot hit the rim. It went to the corner, so the clock then recycled. And then when he picked it up, time went off the clock.
But why would Johnson have taken the shot he did?
Because the clock was winding down.
Well, that was my point. Yeah.
Absolutely. Here's what happens now. The shot is winding. The clock is winding down because David Robinson's shot did not hit the rim. So when he kicks it out, he shoots a desperation shot to beat the clock. It hits the rim. This is great by Avery Johnson. It hits the rim. Now you recycle that shot clock. Now here's another second goes off the clock, and that's what I was talking with only a three-second differential. Now New York is down to 1.4 with this clock.
But they restored 0.7 of a second, and now it's at 2.1.
We were saying the same thing there, Bob. I wasn't sure why you said Avery Johnson took that shot or why the clock didn't recycle. But he had to get that up to try to beat the shot clock because David Robinson didn't hit the rim.
Yeah, we were making the same point, but in the frenzy.
Well, you know what? It's hard. I'm so trained to look up at the shot clock, I can't find it either. So I know what the players must be feeling.
Why didn't the Knicks foul?
Well, that's what I'd said when they were bringing it up, because you run the risk, if you don't get that rebound, that the game is going to be over, number one. Number two, if you foul and they make them both, it's still a three. Will put you in a position to tie. If they miss one, a two ties it. So, you know, Jeff Van Gundy was gambling on the fact they could stop them, get the rebound, and still have enough time to get a shot.
Latrell Sprewell, 35 points in the game. 25 of them in the second half. Allen Houston, 16 points, none of them in this fourth quarter.
Now the ball comes to half court. New York can move it to half court. If you're San Antonio, you want everything being passed away from the basket towards the middle court so they have to catch it and come back and get it. Nothing in the middle, nothing down the sidelines where they can catch and shoot. Make them come back and get it and have to put it on the floor and use some time.
2.1 seconds to an NBA title for the Spurs. Or to a game six Sunday night in San Antonio. Spurs 78, Knicks 77. Ward will throw it in. Delay of game call. And they'll set it back up. Ward to McCain Sprewell. He's underneath. Trying to flex it. The San Antonio Spurs have won their first NBA championship. 26 years coming, and the Knicks made them sweat for every bit of it.
And listen to the New York crowd cheer their team. Bob, they knew they were undermanned. Listen to this. This is a tremendous response to this crowd for the New York Knicks team and their effort.
They tried to spring Sprewell, cutting for the hoop. He caught the pass, but the Spurs converged on him quickly.
That's been the whole factor of this series, is the big man have just not allowed you to score. Now he slips the screen, goes right down the lane, makes the great catch, but look who's there. Tim Duncan, he's pushed underneath the basket, forced to dribble the ball, and David Robinson also comes over, no, realizing you cannot make a pass. The clock is winding down. A tremendous effort by Sprewell to put his team in this position. And let's take a look at San Antonio. Look at David Robinson, Tim Duncan, Mario Elie, Avery Johnson. See David Robinson getting a hug from his father there, Ambrose, his little son. What a moment for the Admiral.
For David Robinson and his wife, Valerie, his three sons, David, Corey, and Justin, here's Jim Gray.
All right, thank you very much. I'm with an obviously very disappointed Latrell Sprewell. Awesome effort by Latrell. Tell us what happened on the last play.
Well, we tried to get a layup off the out, from out of bounds, but they did a good job of really collapsing down. I was too far into the basket, so just tried to get on the other side and make a shot.
Comment about the fight that you guys put up tonight. A lot of people would have expected maybe that this team mailed it in, but that wasn't the case.
No, we fought hard, and we didn't want them celebrating on this floor, but we have to give them credit. They came in, the two big guys played hard for them, and other guys stepped up and made shots as well, and you know, they deserve it.
Your thoughts on the Spurs? Obviously, it's been a long road for David Robinson.
I mean, they deserve it. I mean, they worked hard, and you know, they were the best team this year, and you know, they deserve it. What else can you say?
Final thought. There's been so much controversy surrounding you. Do you want to come back, and do you want to play for Jeff Van Gundy?
Yeah, I plan on coming back.
And play for Jeff?
Yeah.
Latrell, thank you for your time. We appreciate it. Very gracious in defeat. Let's go back over to Bob Costas.
Thank you, Jim. And Jeff Van Gundy said yesterday that he has been told that he will be back as the Knicks coach next year. Tim Duncan making home movies. For Duncan, a title in only his second year. And tonight, he scored 31 points, pulled down 9 rebounds, hit 12 of 22 from the floor. But for David Robinson, a long time coming, a decade in the league. 2 years before he came to the NBA, he was fulfilling his military obligation with the Naval Academy. So he waited 2 years, plus the 10. Sean Elliott, a couple of serious knee operations. Those are the three guys who could be called stars at various times of their careers. The rest of this Spurs team is a collection, and I say this with appreciation, of misfits and rejects and late bloomers.
And best friends, Avery Johnson and David Robinson. They've been through it all here in San Antonio. Apropos that Avery Johnson hit the jump shot on the baseline to give his team the one-point win. Been with this team, this is his third stint with this team, Bob, before he got the championship.
He's one of those survivors, one of those knock-around guys, along with Mario Elie, a seventh-round pick who's played in 4 different leagues, in 4 different countries. Didn't debut in the NBA until he was 27. Or a guy like Jaren Jackson, 8 teams in 8 years. Or Jerome Kersey, who didn't play tonight, but after 15 years, he has his first, there's Elie. After 15 years, Jerome Kersey with his first NBA title. For the first decade of his career, he was a fixture in Portland, a vagabond the next 5 different teams, finally winds up in San Antonio and gets a ring, Jerome Kersey. And Greg Popovich at age 50, an obscure figure on the NBA stage until this year. Sprewell could not have done any more than what he did tonight. Dejection, but he has no reason to feel anything but pride in his personal performance, and in fact, pride in what his team did. An 8th seed that pushed the team that was clearly this year's best in the NBA, not to the full 7 games, but to the limit of their endurance in Game 5. They made them work for everything they got. And when they go home to San Antonio with the championship trophy, they'll also leave with a healthy respect for the team they beat to get it.
And Bob, would you expect anything different from Tim Duncan? Taking movies, sort of stepping back, watching the whole thing, that cool, calm demeanor that we've seen the entire playoffs. And just to echo what you said about New York, tremendous effort. And I'm so happy for Jeff Van Gundy that he is going to be back. What a tremendous job he did with his team. We saw Allen Houston become a star in the NBA Finals in the playoffs.
Greg Popovich, Air Force product, 5 years in the Air Force. Following his collegiate stint there, majored in Soviet studies. There's been some talk, which he won't confirm. He just gives you a wry grin that at one point he was ticketed for a slot with the CIA. Instead, he wound up bouncing around as a college coach and a pro assistant, now the coach and general manager of the NBA champions. We're ready for the presentation of the trophy. And we go up to the podium. Here's Ahmad.
It is now time for the 1999 championship presentation. Joining me on the podium, the San Antonio Spurs co-owners, Peter Holt, Juliana Holt, general manager, coach, Greg Popovich, co-captains, David Robinson, and Avery Johnson somewhere. And now for the presentation, here's NBA Commissioner David Stern.
Thank you to the Spurs and the Knicks for giving us a great series. Congratulations to the New York Knicks and their fans for this season and this very exciting run. To the San Antonio Spurs, it was a spectacular series. To them, their fans, to their fans across America, congratulations, 1999 NBA champion, San Antonio Spurs.
San Antonio, a great ride. What's this mean to the city?
Oh, it means everything to our great fans who've hung with us for 26 years, the great owners that have owned this team for 26 years. Nothing better, nothing better.
And a historical win, Juliana, because the first ABA team to win an NBA championship.
Absolutely. I want to thank God for this fabulous team and the chance to be associated with such extraordinary gentlemen and most fantastic ball players of all time.
All right, congratulations. David Robinson. David. Co-captain David Robinson. You've been through many coaches, many changes, and finally an NBA championship. What's it mean to you?
I'll tell you. To me, this is just a journey that just goes to show that hard work and persistence pays off, baby. I love these guys. And I tell you what, one thing I learned to do this year was trust the Lord through the whole thing. He blessed me, he blessed his team, he took us to the top, and if you learn anything from this, baby, learn that the Lord doesn't give up on his people, baby, he takes you all the way.
Avery Johnson, Avery Johnson, here's the man.
That's what I'm talking about, first of all.
Everybody said, Avery, that you couldn't lead a team to a championship. Those days are over with now.
Little big man.
Yes, Ahmad, we're just so thankful for this opportunity. My teammates, they believe in me. Pop believes in me. The Lord Jesus believes in me, and that gives me a lot of confidence.
All right, congratulations to you. All right, now it's time for our presentation of the Finals MVP Award. And to make that presentation, once again, David Stern.
Ladies and gentlemen, join me in applauding a spectacular athlete, a terrific young man, who averaged 27 points and 14 rebounds to be the most valuable player of the 1999 NBA Finals, Tim Duncan.
That is the most emotion that I've seen you show throughout this entire playoffs. But this has got to mean something for you.
Oh, yeah.
And all of a sudden, everybody.
Oh, man, this is incredible.
The league. All of a sudden, you win the MVP award.
This is incredible. It feels so great out here. The teammates came out here, and we had a tough game tonight. We pulled it out. We kept our focus throughout. We wanted to finish it now, and we did. We did a great job with it.
All right, congratulations to you.
Thank you.
All right, let's go back over to Bob Costas.
Well, the Knicks used their last-second miracles in earlier series. Houston versus the Heat. Larry Johnson, the impossible four-point play against the Pacers. Tonight, the law of averages and the Spurs caught up with New York.